I know initially she was very scared. And I think a lot of kids would be, considering she was watching her grandmother go through something similar. My name is Emily Creighton. I am the mother of Isabella Snow Fraser, who was diagnosed with ASPS in the year of 2016. She ended up reaching over the bathtub and getting a bump on her arm. And initially, the doctors thought it was a really deep bruise and it never went away, which led to an ultrasound. She was taken for a biopsy. It was about a week later that I got the call. And that's when we discovered it was alveolar soft part sarcoma. Honestly, I collapsed. After the diagnosis of my mother and then my daughter, not just to be diagnosed with cancer, but one of the rarest cancers in the world. It was a very scary situation, but got right back up and I said, we're gonna fight this and work towards a cure. They took it out of her arm. They took a little extra out of her nerves. Then we went back for routine scans, MRIs and CAT scans to ensure that it was no longer growing. About 5 years passed, and I was actually involved with some online forums of fellow patients of ASPS, and one of them recommended, go get more scans. They did one of her chest area, and they found that had moved to her lungs. My mother was diagnosed late, so she had stage 4 lung and brain cancer. She'd ask me questions like, Mom, am I gonna be like Grammy? Am I gonna turn out like that? And I had to reassure her, not today. We've got a battle to fight. She took that in stride and wiped away tears and knows that the medicine will help her overall to live a good life. After it was discovered in her lungs, we started trial for oral chemotherapy. We were on that for about a year. Nothing was really working. Luckily, one of Bella's providers called me. Hey, there's this very promising trial of Tecentriq and Bella qualifies and we would love to have her jump on this. We first started the trial. We had to travel to Washington, D.C. for treatments, which left me out of work for weeks at a time, so I had to change jobs. It was one of the first struggles so I could be closer to Belle, closer to home. Bella missed a lot of school for the treatments initially, but now every 3 weeks down in Boston, it works okay. It's still a 3-4 hour trip to and from. It's been remarkable in the ways that, first of all, the cancer has stopped growing. We haven't seen any growth in over a year. There are little to no side effects whatsoever. It was like Bella being back to normal. You wouldn't even know that she was fighting cancer at this point. Before, she was tired. She couldn't really get out of bed. She wouldn't eat. Now her appetite is healthy. She wants to eat. She's active. She's doing awesome. She's still smiling. Going through pictures earlier from before and after of the treatment, it's amazing to see how positive she stays throughout it all. She's a champion. When it comes to cancer, I would like people to really think about what does cancer look like? It's more than just focusing on the patient. It's the families, it's the communities. Without trials such as these, and without the funds to make this medicine happen, she wouldn't be able to run around like she does today. She wouldn't be able to have the family and friends she has. She gets to live a normal life. She gets to smile more. Without funding, without these treatments, it just ends.